Now let's look at the first application of the steady flow energy equation, or in short SFEE. And the first application we talk about is on nozzles and diffusers. Now first of all, we need to understand the difference between a nozzle and a diffuser, because these two devices are extensively used in a lot of engineering applications. Okay, so these are the two diagrams which you should remember and understand to differentiate between these two devices. Okay, so you have some fluid entering and leaving in both the cases. Okay, so first of all, what is a nozzle? What is a nozzle? Well, a nozzle is a device which increases the velocity of a fluid at the expense of its pressure. Okay, so you need to understand this and remember that in a nozzle, the velocity increases and the pressure decreases. Alright, now we come to the second one, which is diffuser. Now what is a diffuser? It is the opposite of the nozzle. So in a diffuser, the velocity decreases and the pressure increases. Okay, now which one of them is a nozzle and which one of them is a diffuser? Let's look at the continuity equation. The continuity equation says that Q, which is also a symbol for discharge, this is equal to A1 V1, which is equal to A2 into V2. Area into velocity is a constant value at entrance and at exit. Okay. Now if you compare this one, let us say this is section 1 and this is section 2. Okay, similarly in this is section 1 and this is section 2. Alright. Now in the first diagram, we know that the area 1 by area 2, this ratio is greater than 1 because area 1 is more than area 2. Okay. So if you compare these two equations, you would have A1 upon A2, A1 upon A2, this is equal to V2 upon V1. Okay, now because A1 upon A2 is more than 1, so will be V2 by V1. This means that V2 would be more than V1. Now means we have a higher velocity at exit. Okay, so let us say this is V1 and this is V2. Okay, so V2 is higher as compared to V1. So you get higher velocity, or the velocity increases at outlet in which one of these two devices? That is nozzle. Okay, so this device is nothing but nozzle. Okay, now let's come to the second thing. Now, but of course, if this is nozzle, this has to be diffuser. Now let's derive something which makes it a diffuser. Okay, so in this, again we'll apply the continuity equation. So Q is equal to A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. Now in this, A1 is less than A2. A1 upon A2 is less than 1. Okay, so if you compare these two equations, you will get A1 by A2 is equal to V2 by V1, which is less than 1. This means V2 is less than V1. So you have lower velocity at exit. Okay, and that is the case in the case of a diffuser. So this becomes a diffuser. Okay, so I hope now you are able to understand and recognize any given diagram as a nozzle, as a diffuser. Okay, now let's apply the SFEE on a nozzle. So let us say this is that device that we call as a nozzle. So this is a convergent divergent nozzle. So you are converging up till certain section and then you start diverging. Okay, so this part over here, this is the convergent section. This is the convergent section. Okay, this is the divergent section. And this part is the throat area. Alright. Now, The nozzle is insulated, so because it is insulated from the outside, the heat loss is zero. Okay, and because it's a nozzle, there is no perceivable usable work output from it, so work output is also zero. Okay, now if I take this as my reference plane, the entry level and the exit level of the fluid is at the same level. So the potential energy difference is also zero, isn't it? You are entering at velocity V1 and going out at velocity V2. Now you enter, or not you, but the steam enters at certain enthalpy and it exits at certain enthalpy. So these two things are different. So if you write down the SFEE, now what was SFEE if you remember it? Q dot minus W dot is equal to M dot into delta H plus delta KE plus delta PE, isn't it? Now in this particular equation, I have this as 0, this as 0, this is 0, so only these two things are left. Now M dot cannot be 0, so the only two things which are 0 are H and KE. Okay, so you will have H2 minus H1 plus V2 square minus V1 square by 2 equal to 0. So this is the equation that we call the SFEE for a nozzle or a diffuser. Okay, and this is how we derive it. So I hope you understood this analysis on the application of steady flow equation on a nozzle and a diffuser. Now let's move on to the second application of SFEE and talk about gas turbines and steam turbines.